Hi, Gary.
How are you?
Good, you all right?
Yeah, good, thanks.
You said a few weeks ago, Gary, that it would take an astronomical bid for the club to do business with Wilfred Boney. Is £28 million an astronomical figure?
I think so. I said before that, you know, I've had discussions with the club and obviously with this situation and spoke to the chairman very closely, and I think you have to take a lot of things into consideration when these opportunities come up for players, and obviously from a club perspective and obviously from a manager's perspective. And like I said before, we always do what's best for the club. We felt this was the right deal for us, and ultimately it has to be right for the club, and that's what we did with this decision.
Was there any persuading him to stay? Was that ever a possibility at any stage?
Oh, look, I've got a fantastic relationship with Wilfred. Always have since I've been doing this job, and worked very closely with him, and I knew his views on things, but I think you could see from all his performances how committed he was to Swansea City, to myself, the team, his teammates, to produce good football for us and score goals. And then when this opportunity comes around, of course, you have to consider the players' views and my own views, the team's views, the club's views, and once you have those discussions, you have to do what's best for the club, and obviously this decision was best for the player and best for the club.
What kind of difference do you think he'll make at Manchester City?
I think he'd be fantastic. We all know the quality that he has as a player. What he produced here, you know, going to a club like Manchester City with the players, world-class players that he'd be playing with week in, week out. You know, the chances that they create throughout games, I think he'd do fantastically well, and hopefully he goes there and produces the kind of football that he helped produce here, and I'm sure he'll do that.
Could he give them the edge in the title race?
Who knows? Obviously, that's up to their manager now and his team selections, and I'm sure Wilfred will want to be part of it all, and Champions League football, Premier League football. So Wilfred be going up there is a good challenge for him as a player, and you know, it's definitely for myself and the club. We wish him all the best, for sure.
You have to find a way of replacing him here. Is that player already here, or do you need to go out and find someone?
No, I've said all along, I'd already prepared for this period anyway, with losing Wilfred and Baffy. We brought Nelson in, Oliveira as well. I've said before, Baffy's my number one striker, and going on forward from this point is looking for Baffy and Nelson to contribute really well to the team. And, you know, they're very understanding already of how we play and how we work, which is not to be underestimated, you know, in terms of how we do things. And they're already up to speed with how we go about our job, and hopefully they get that chance now. Baffy gets his chance and to produce, and I'm sure that he'll do very well for myself, for the team, and the club going forward.
Can Baffy replace Wilfred Boney?
Baffy's a different player. Players, strikers, there's all different types out there. Baffy's a different striker to Boney, but Baffy's a top quality striker in his own right, and he's proven that throughout his whole career. He's proven that to myself in the time that he's been here, albeit that he's not had as much game time as he would have liked, but the quality is there for everyone to see. I see it every single day, and I have no problem whatsoever with Baffy. I think he'll show in the coming games the quality that he has.
He continues to be linked with other clubs. Mm. Is he definitely staying here?
Yeah, I said 100%. You know, I can't affect what goes on outside of this club, what's said in the papers and media. It's out of my hands, out of my control. What I can control is what we do here at the club and what the players do day in, day out. Baffy works extremely hard day in, day out. His commitment is there for myself to see and for his teammates to see. And my focus is on Baffy now for the rest of the season to produce his best football for us, and hopefully, with the way that I work and understanding with him, to help produce his best football.
So have there been any inquiries, any bids for him?
No, nothing at all. Like I said, speculation is speculation. I don't worry myself with any of that. I just worry about making sure the players are prepared for the game coming up at the weekend.
Now you've got a few quid in your pocket. Have you had a meeting with the chairman about how much of that you're able to spend?
No, it's not something that I consider or right at this point. I've mentioned it before. I'm sure that, you know, everyone thinks that now you have 28 million or 28 million pound that's going to be coming into the club at whatever point is all spent on players. Of course it's not. This club, we use it wisely. We always have done. There's infrastructure to improve. There's plenty of things off the field that we need to improve. Stadium expansions, training grounds, facilities like that, which cost a lot of money, but it's something that, you know, the club will put in place to make sure that the future of the club is solid, and I think that's quite rightly so. So in terms of a budget for myself, for players, of course, we need to sign players, we need to add quality to the squad, which is important, but it won't be what the money that people are trying to tout at this moment.
You're not looking for a striker then in this window?
No, not at all. Baffy and Nelson, I'm 400% confidence in the two players. Baffy especially at this point has the shirt and it's his to lose, and the quality he has, I have no reservations whatsoever in terms of he'll produce that quality for us and the team going forward.
You've been linked with a few other players, Gary, again this week. Martin Olsen at Norwich, any interest there?
How many more are on your list there before you ask
one
me?
Or two.
Should we do them all? Listen, speculation, links. I understand it. I understand you have to ask the question, but you know, of course, we have targets that we'd like to go for. But I don't like to speak about specific players or specific names because I find that's disrespectful to other clubs that they're at. So, in terms of who we go for, yes, we have a numerous network that we try and narrow down and shortlist to try and target. But it's then down to availability and affordability. But in terms of names linked here, there, and everywhere, it's part of it.
One other name just to throw at you, Mitrovic at Anderlecht. Been going on for a while.
I said that list is getting longer, didn't I? But no, listen, all names will be linked with us at all. I know what players that I would like to come and help add to the quality that we already have here to help the team that are already here, the squad that are already here. So it's about us trying to identify them, narrow it down, and obviously if something concrete comes along, you'll be the first one to know, okay?
Glad to know. You mentioned Nelson Oliveira. Came off the bench on Saturday.
Yeah.
Is he likely to start this weekend?
No, look, I assess the players all week. We try and work hard on the preparation for each game. And in terms of the team selection, I haven't selected the team yet. I think we've got final training tomorrow. And then I'll obviously have a closer look at the players as I do all throughout the week. And you can never really judge it until the final training session's over because of injuries or any niggles or anything like that can happen at any moment. So really it's getting through the training session tomorrow, assessing the players, sitting down and then picking the team from there, really.
How big a challenge is this weekend? What have you made at Chelsea this week?
Oh, I've said before, for me, a fantastic team, exceptional players, world-class players all over the pitch. Probably the strongest squad I've ever seen at Chelsea. In all my time watching them and growing up, watching Chelsea teams. Obviously an exceptional manager as well. They are where they are. I said long before, I think I said at the start of the season, that they were my favourites to win the league. I still believe that. Albeit they have a good competition from teams in and around them, especially Man City. But no, I think they're an exceptional team and a real talented team, one of the best in Europe. So it's a really good challenge for us. It's a challenge for my players, for myself, to really try and put on a performance that hopefully we can warrant a good performance and a good result.
Their manager seems to become increasingly exasperated lately with referees. Any advice for Jose?
No, listen, I only concentrate on my own situation with my own team and those types of situations. I've talked about them. So really, to give advice to anyone else, I'm sure he's very experienced and versed in these situations. So no, not at all.
And just to go back to the goal-scoring issue, you haven't scored a lot of goals lately. Do you feel that there's enough here to break down a team like Chelsea who don't concede many away from home?
Yeah, for sure. Every team has... You know, you have a chance in every single game to score goals. I don't really buy into the fact you're saying that we haven't scored too many goals. I think the points tally that we have, the points that we gathered over the Christmas period have been very, very, very good. And, you know, we keep ticking over, we keep trying to put the points on the board, and I don't care if we win 1-0 or we win 7-0, as long as we get the points on the board, that's the main thing. And, you know, we work incredibly hard to create situations. We create numerous good chances in every single game that we've played, no matter how we've played. So in terms of those chances that we're creating, they do warrant more goals. But as long as we're gathering the points on a regular basis, that's all that matters.
Great. Thanks, Gary.
Cheers.
Just one from me. You mentioned about the club's infrastructure needing to be improved, the stadium, the training ground. That, I guess, will largely depend on whether this American investment comes through or not. Is there any news, as far as you can tell us about that, about the potential American money coming into the club? Is there any latest at all?
No, I think it is as it was. There was talks going on, whether those talks are still continuing. I don't think the intense talks are going on right now. I think they're still liaising and talking, and the club are seeking the views of different people and different avenues, and quite rightly so, like I said before. So it's a way to expand the club and for the future to consolidate even more. But as I said before, the club will always do what's best for Swansea City, and you know, you've got a chairman and a board that again, well versed in the history of the club and understanding of where we've come from and how to get better and how to improve for the future. So, you know, it's in safe hands, whatever happens in the future. But in terms of those talks, it's the same as it was.
Cheers, Gary.
Cheers.
Gary, I wonder the whole situation with Wilfred. Some people might say it's a bit of a double-edged sword in the fact that, you know, complimenting in terms of what Swansea have done for Wilfred Boney, and he's acknowledged that publicly, but also the fact that some of these big clubs come cherry-picking here. How do you view it as the manager?
I think you said it there. I think it's bittersweet, really. I think, of course, we're disappointed to lose such a good player, you know, an important player for us, and not just that, but a character around the group, a big personality. It's disappointing to lose, you know, a good player that he was. But I kind of feel proud about it as well. You know, I think the fact that, you know, myself, his teammates, the club itself have played, you know, a good part in his development as a player and improved him as a player in his time here to allow him a platform to perform and score the goals that he has and to produce a player that we brought in for, you know, a reasonable amount of money, which was a big investment for the club at the time, but to sell him for the profit that we have and, you know, to produce a £28 million player at this club, which is a record for the club. And again, I'm versed in the history of the club and where we've come from and, you know, these sums of money that we're talking about. I feel quite proud about it. I feel good that I've played a part in his development and to help him, and like I just talked about, the club have, his teammates have, and, you know, like I said before, we wish him all the best, we really do. And, you know, he deserves this chance. It's very hard as well when you've got a player that has always talked about trying to play at the highest level. All the players want to play at the highest level, and it's a chance for him to do that. So he goes definitely with our blessing.
And, you know, he's been very public. You know, he's said it and it's been put into print about, you know, his feelings about Swansea and the welcome he got here and the support he got here. Would there be one ingredient? Could you put it down to one ingredient, pinpoint about what turned Wilfred Boney from a £12 million player into a, you know, close to a £30 million player? You know, I mean, we've spoken to the other players about, you know, the work ethic that you've got and that you push them through. Is it down to that? Is it a latent talent that just needed to come out because of this platform?
Yeah.
Could you pinpoint it to anything?
I think it's a number of things. I think, obviously, when Wilfred first signed, he found it difficult. He wasn't in the team so much, and, you know, he's finding it difficult at that point. But Boney's one of them where you give him the confidence, you work with him day in, day out to try and help him in his performance, and obviously you build the team around a player like that to be able to give him the chances and understand the way that Boney plays and improve him as a player. And I try to work really hard with him on that side of it, plus his personality, try to bring that into the group more and give him the importance that he is as a player and as a person to influence the group as well. And I think all of those things, I think he was really understanding and very clever in the way that I was trying to work and how I wanted him to work and certain aspects of his game and stuff like that. And I think that all contributed, along with the desire the player has to have. One thing he has to have is desire to do it and to perform it and get better and better. And Boney was always one that wanted to get better and better. And ultimately, that work rate, the way of working, the improvement as a player, as we helped him, has gotten him to this point and managed to secure a move to Man City and a Champions League club that he always wanted to do. And
have you got another Boney? I'm not necessarily saying necessarily a striker, but a player that you can see that in, that specialness, that sort of almost intrinsic ingredient that set him apart?
I think strikers are quite unique. I think they're unique in the sense of the baggage that comes with them, the label that they have, you know, the goal scorers of each club, they always attract the most interest. And if you can work with them and you can produce them and get them better, they always attract the bigger clubs. The more price, the fees that you pay for the strikers are always higher than probably any other position. But yes, we have players that can potentially, you know, go on to play for bigger clubs and you know, Champions League football. That I think now it could hopefully open the gateway that, you know, teams look at Swansea, that we can produce players. Not that we want teams coming in taking all our players or anything, but that here at Swansea, the way that we work, what we've got in place is a chance for players to really, you know, improve themselves as players and have a benchmark, you know, that you can come to places like this and go on to bigger and better things and not just, you know, start from the bottom and work your way up, but it's also come in maybe a step down to start again and to make your way back up again. So I just think it's credit to Swansea as a whole. I think it's credit to myself, the staff, the players, the club itself, that, you know, we've put everything in place to be able to allow these players to produce their best football, which is the most important bit.
But it would be nice for Swansea to be in the position to be one of the clubs looking to cherry pick elsewhere, wouldn't it?
Oh, of course it would. But I think we understand what we are and where we're trying to get to and the future that we're trying to produce. And at this moment in time, we know where we're at. It's trying to get better and better and edge and improve that a little bit more each season, and hopefully in the future we can be a bigger club than we are now.
Just one last one for me, just about Gilfie. I mean, saying about, you know, obviously he's had this injury, you've been nursing him through it and everything. I mean, you know, it's so wonderful to have him back in the squad. I guess he's going to miss Wilfred because they set up a great relationship there. Can you see him setting that up with somebody else?
Yeah, of course. And you know, I think, you know, the games that, you know, when you have intelligent players, you know, Baffy's an intelligent player, Gilfie's an intelligent player, you know, in terms of those roles in those situations, I think they can play with anyone. I think they're clever enough to play with any type of player. And, you know, Baffy's an intelligent player. I'm looking really forward to this period now with Baffy to, I think we've already seen in the games that he's come in, you know, QPR, the Tranmere game. I thought the game against West Ham, I thought he was excellent. And he'll only get better and better with more minutes and the understanding of a team. Of course, you have to tweak certain things because different players do different things. Baffy will do different things to whatever Boney did, but I don't really compare the two. They're different players. But what I know is Baffy is a top quality player, Nelson as well, to complement that and an understanding of what the team need to do to when these players are playing, and that's what my job is.